Hi guys, it's Anthony Molinaro from O'Brien Real Estate with the 41st edition of the Eastern Weekly Property News for 2021, where the real estate information is on the house. The Reserve Bank meeting on Melbourne Cup Day in 2020 saw interest rates cut to an historical low. This year, as expected, the RBA kept rates at historical lows, with the market still hot coming towards the end of the calendar year. Now, as we do at the start of every month, we report on the data that CoreLogic recently released for the previous month. Nationally, we saw another 1.49% increase in October, similar to what we saw in September and August, although 0.1% not as promising. Regional Victoria is leading the way with its growth, with an overall increase of 1.7% for all dwellings, taking the annual growth to 23.4%. Metro Melbourne across the country is still holding up the rear, equal with Perth against all the other capital cities, with an overall 1% increase, with a 16.4% change in the last 12 months. Amazingly, Hobart has experienced 33.8% growth in overall prices, followed by Canberra at 30.1% and Sydney in third place with 28.2% growth. Looking at the next slide on rental performance, you'll see that for property investors, Melbourne's rent market growth hasn't been great at all for them. Rents in Melbourne have only modestly increased 4.5% in a booming market, whereas the rest of the country have had at least double the return. Darwin is sitting on top with a 19.5% increase in their rents for houses. Hobart at 13.8%, Perth at 13.1%, Brisbane at 11.4%, Sydney at 9.9%, Canberra at 9.7%, and Adelaide at 9.2%. The situation is even worse for units, although there has been a remarkable turnaround from the 16% drop in rents over 2020, with rents for units in Melbourne are only at 0.2% growth for the year, with the rest of the country a lot better off, with Sydney at 5.8% being the lowest and Darwin again at 18.5%. The good news is, since the end of the rental eviction moratorium in March 2021, we have seen growth in rents paid returning, and we believe the catch-up will happen for Melbourne and regional Victoria well into 2022. We also expect investor demand across the unit sector to be bolstered as overseas borders open, which is likely to have a positive impact on the rental demand. Rental providers in Victoria are also improving their properties in accordance with the new minimum standards handed down in May this year, when the Residential Tenancy Act was updated. There is a 2-year grace period for existing properties to be bought up to the speed with the changes, but we are finding many of our owners are acting now and getting well ahead of the curve. The main news edits this week have been that many leading indicators that the economy is opening back up will be released in the coming days, weeks, and months. Manufacturing was released last week, hitting a 4-month high. Car sales and building approvals will be released during this week, and building approvals are currently sitting at a 36-month high, with car sales at a 25-month high. We'll also see the trade figures released, and we expect to see an increase of the record $109.8 billion from the month of August. Property of the week this week is number 9 McCallick Street, Nuttawadding. Lived and loved in over the years, this family home has your vision tinkering from the outside in. The substantial corner allotment, measuring approximately 718 square metres, allows the option to either extend, build your dream home, renovate the existing property, or take advantage of the corner block and build multiple dwellings. It's choices like these that give you the benefit of purchasing in one of Nuttawadding's tightly held pockets. Comprising 3 spacious bedrooms, a large lounge room, central kitchen, bathroom and separate toilet, a sunroom or second living area, and a spacious laundry leading you to the enormous backyard. Key features, well, that includes heating, gas cooktop, air conditioning, 2 storage sheds and a single carport. In a stunning location and only moments from highly desirable primary and secondary schools, numerous bus routes and Nuttawadding train station, the Eastern Freeway providing you easy access to the CBD and close to an array of shopping precincts. When it comes to endless choices and possibilities, the buck absolutely stops here. Priced to sell and to be auctioned on the 27th of November at 3 p.m, this could be the best corner allotment available in the last 12 months in the suburb of Nuttawadding. Now that's all for this week. I'm Anthony Molinaro, and remember, the information provided is of a general nature. You should always seek independent legal, financial, taxation, or other advice in relation to your unique circumstances. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this week's Market Wrap. And until next week, well, it's bye for now.